It's another one, myself, SK Vibemaker, Rinse FM, Rinse TV, and we got a very special guest in the building. Not everyday interview, you know. Northwest London in the building, Halsden, Ice City Boys, Skrapz, what's happening, man?
What's going on, brother? You good, yeah?
Oh, it is very good that you've come down to the Rinse FM building today, man.
Nah, man, thanks for having me, bro.
How does it feel to be out with your second album, man? Eagerly anticipated.
I don't know, it feels kind of normal, innit? It was part of the plan, so yeah, I'm just getting on with it.
Different cloth, 2 years between projects. I mean, I don't just say this to everybody. Very strong.
Bless.
I mean, are you happy with the feedback that you've been getting for the project?
Yeah. More than happy. It's like they're understanding it how I thought they would or how they should, innit? Because not every time you could put out something and people don't take to it how you think they are gone or whatever. But yeah, this time around, it's like they understand it.
I mean, I'm not saying a lot has changed in 2 years, but quite a bit's changed with the technology since you first came out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Have you noticed with this project that you've gained a different type of fan base? Are you noticing a different fan base at all?
Yeah, I know. Like, my core fan base is there. Like, they've been there. Even when I was quiet, they were still there. And then it's like, I don't know, yeah, it has attracted a kind of new fan base as well. But I think they was always like, they was always around, but they just never felt anything like how they're feeling this one kind of, or people just more open about it now kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I mean, you are very respected as a rapper in the UK. Very respected. Like, a lot of artists talk about you as being like an influencer and stuff. For the record, how would you sort of describe the musical journey so far, Skrapz?
I think it's just been organic, if I just sum it up in one word. Like, I think like how I can break it down is I've taken like the stairs in it to get to where I'm going instead. Enough man's taken the lift in it, like they just get a quick bus or one tune just takes them off or whatever. But fair play to them, but I think I've taken like the stairs and grown my thing kind of organically.
Mm-hmm. And was that the plan, to take the stairs?
Yeah, definitely.
The slow grow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And we're happy because, you know, there's artists that come out with a boom, burn out quickly.
Yeah.
You're definitely
seasonal. I call a lot of music what I hear seasonal, innit? Like, it's just seasonal. It's going to be here for a certain amount of time, then the new season comes, innit? But I think my thing works through all seasons kind of thing.
Enemies.
Yes.
I have to say, there was a particular line in there that sticks out to me. Very important. They got me feeling like there's no one in my lane, like I'm driving in the hard shoulder.
Yeah. That's early in the track, innit?
I love that line. Is that like the opening? That's like the opening line, right?
Yeah. Or the second line or something.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, that's the unmistakable flow, the unmistakable voice. And, you know, just in case people question, like, if this is something that you're putting on or anything, they're watching this interview now, they're hearing this interview.
Mm.
This is your voice, man.
Yeah.
I mean, you actually
rap
in your voice. There's a lot of rappers that don't rap in their voice.
Yeah, I get that a lot. Like, people approach me and say to me, "Bro, you sound like how you rap." But I say, how am I supposed to sound like? It's me that's rapping, innit?
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I don't know. It's nothing forced, innit? It's just all normal, so when people like shed light on the fact that I sound like how I rap, to me, that's how it's supposed to sound, innit?
Mm-hmm.
You're not meant to change your voice or your who you are just to, you know what I mean? Otherwise, it's not genuine, it's not real.
How did it feel when you saw Anthony Joshua coming out to fight Vladimir Klitschko coming out to your music, man?
Yeah, I can't even explain. There's no word to explain that feeling there, innit? It's just a big moment. It was a big part of my life, and it was like, yo, like the fight was major, and it's not like it was no little fight. It was a big fight.
Mm-hmm.
And secretly, like, man knew it was coming. I wasn't supposed to know, but like I got a little heads up still, so I was kind of expecting it. But still, I think the feeling might have been different if it happened as a surprise. But regardless, it was still mad, innit? Like, I was there, innit? I was in the stadium. There's, like, I think 90,000 people, plus everybody who's watching at home on TV and all of that as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was mad. Like, people that weren't expecting it, like, mama's hitting me up. They're saying that when they heard the beat drop, they was thinking, yo, that sounds like Skrapz's tune, but it's like you won't ever think that it's gonna be me, and then you hear my voice and it's like, yo, innit? But yeah, it was crazy, man. It was crazy.
A co-sign from the champ.
Yeah, it was mad. Big Jeez. Up AJ, man.
Have you had any conversation since?
Like, yeah. I hit him up to say thank you and all of that. But he's cool, man. He's good people. He's always supporting man's thing, like on his social media and that. So yeah, man, big up AJ.
Love. Do you remember the point in which you realised that music is a serious career for you, when you actually got your voice, when you found like this is the point?
Yeah and no. Like, I'm still in the process of making a transition. A lot of people like find that hard to believe. Like, I know this is what I'm doing and this is like my career kind of thing, but it's just like there's a lot of obstacles in the way what kind of change the plan sometimes, innit? So it's just about getting through them and just keeping it moving kind of thing. But I think it was more like, yeah, when I started selling music, because a lot of my music, the mixtapes, what you was mentioning,
free downloads.
Yeah, there was free downloads. So once I made the end of the beginning and put that out for sale on the digitals and all of that, it's like once you start recouping and seeing what can actually happen, that's when you gotta start taking things a bit more seriously, kinda. But then there was obstacles after that, what sent things left again, and then, yeah. It's just about trying to stay on track, really.
I always see a legend when I'm walking past the mirror.
Mm-hmm.
I need to start feeling like that myself, too.
Yeah, man.
That's a good feeling to feel.
Yeah, trust.
Every day, looking in the mirror, just feeling like you're seeing it, yeah?
100.
I like that, man. I mean,
self-belief, though, innit? It's just knowing, innit, that no one ain't gonna tell you that, but you just gotta know, innit?
Mm-hmm. What's a regular track making process for Skrapz? How does it go down in the studio? I mean, are you solo in the studio? I mean, is there loads of people? Is it dark lit? Is it light? Is it daytime, nighttime?
To know, like, when it comes to studio, I don't have a preference. Like, I could be solo, get the job done. I could have my whole team in there screaming and shouting. I could get the job done. Like, I could have smoke. I need smoke, something. Like, it's got to be there. Juice is like optional. But yeah, I can work in any kind of conditions because I've been in so much different kind of studios, like in a man's bedroom, in a man's garage, in a mad studio, a small one. Like, I've been in all kind of environments when it comes to studio.
Mm-hmm.
And I can always get the job done. But I feel like nighttime, I work best at nighttime.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but as far as lighting and all that, it's not that deep, yeah.
I'm trying to, I think I was kind of doing this little case study to myself the other day, because I listen to a lot of your music, and it's very hard to find a song where you don't say boom. People said that to you a lot before.
Yeah,
that's, I mean, like the signature ad lib.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it kind of like, it's people, it's kind of like the response what made me keep doing it, innit? Like, at first it was just something what I used to say without realising.
Yeah.
It was just something, and then people highlighted the fact that I always say it, and then I could bump into someone and they're just like, boom. They don't even say what I go on and they're just like, boom. So yeah, it's just like, I just got it as my trademark kind of thing.
Sick.
Mm.
People that don't know, they might find it hard to believe that back in the day, you was part of a grime collective,
yeah.
SLK.
Yeah.
I mean, it's quite an evolution and a change. You know, if you listen to Different Cloth, which is your latest album, and you go back to SLK days, is that the same Skrapz? Like?
Yeah, it's a crazy evolution.
You could have been out here in 2017 as a grime MC. How about that?
Yeah, I used to like mingle in the rap, dabble in the rap a lot, like. And I always found it easier to express myself on a rap beat rather than grime, because grime, you just kind of have to just say things, innit, just to rhyme or whatever sounds. But on a hip-hop beat, on a rap beat, you can break it down and say what you really want to say. You ain't got to squeeze your bar into a little second or nothing, you know what I mean? So, like, it was always part of what I was doing. And then, it's like, yeah, the grime thing, that broke down just due to there was too many of us in the team. So when it came to like shows or whatever, like we weren't capitalizing kind of money wise, and it was just getting, and I'm a man, I don't like to invest my time into nothing that don't we don't profit from it, you know what I mean? That's just how I've been from young.
I mean, you got High Specs, the song with Chip.
Yeah.
This is special, man.
Yeah.
I mean, this is, talk to us how this came together.
With this, it's mad because Chip hit me up to jump on a remix of one of the tracks on his album. I'm not going to say the track yet, but it was a track from his album. He wanted to do a remix to it, so he sent over the beat and all of that. But when I heard the beat, I was still in the process of making my album. So when I heard the beat, I was thinking, yeah, my album's missing this kind of vibe, innit? So I asked him who was the producer, and he's saying it's the Fanatics, and he's saying he's going to put me in contact with them or whatever. But what happened is next time he went to a session, next time he was in the studio, he just phoned me when he was there. And he was like, yo, I'm here now, I'm going to flick through something and then I'll send you something over. And then by morning, he sent that beat, innit? And when I heard it, I was like, yo, all right, cool. I wanted him to put a hook on it for me. Like, just put a hook on and then I'll do the verses. But we just arranged the session where we just both link up. And then from we linked up, he just had like the vibes in the booth and all of that, in the studio, he just had the vibes. So he set it. He set like the whole vibe for the track. He went in there first and just done his thing.
Nice.
Yeah, nice. Shout out, Chip. And then, yeah, from there, just went like that.
History.
Mm.
What's the plan for ICT Boys going on here, running, man?
Everyone's just working, man. Jay Styles just dropped a video. It's out there now, Wave. Fats is working, Streets is working. You already know Nines is working. Yeah, everyone's just working. A lot of projects dropping next year, visuals. Hopefully the man them can go on tour. That's the plan. And yeah.
What we saying? Collaborative album, Skrapz and Nines. You reckon that will ever happen?
Yeah, of course it will happen. I just can't tell you when, but it's 100%.
Keep the people just waiting.
Yeah. I can't put a date on it. Nines tried to put a date on it in some interview. Not a date, but he gassed them up in it and the socials went too crazy.
We saying 2023 or something like that, yeah?
Mad like that. Yeah.
It's been another one myself, SK Vibemaker for Rinse TV with Skrapz, man.
Yeah, man, shout out SK Vibemakers, big boy Skrapz, one and only, different cloth out there now, boom.